Greetings. It is important to understand the errors and techniques of deception used by Islam. Honestly, the subtlety of the deception makes it hard to detect, let alone resist at times. Let's listen to Mr. Islam, Ahmed Deedat.
And according to the Muslim belief, there is no such thing as Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. It is only Islam.
According to Muslim belief, there is no such thing as Judaism or Christianity. It is only Islam. Don't be shocked by that statement. That is the whole deception and subterfuge to subvert God's message in the earth. This is not Mr. Deedat making crap up. He is faithfully presenting the false message of Mohammed's religion. The whole plan of Satan, from the start of Islam, is to subvert the message of the gospel and deny both the Son of God and Satan's defeat at the cross. Satan could not defeat Jesus by killing Jesus on the cross. In fact, Jesus dying on the cross was a victory for God. Revelation 13:8, "And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world." 1 Corinthians 2:7, "But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom, which God ordained before the world unto our glory, which none of the princes of this world knew, for had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory." You see, God's plan from before he created the worlds was that his Son would redeem man from the sin God knew would enter creation. Or do you think God does not know everything? Do you think God does not know the future?
In the verse I read to you from the Holy Quran,
all who follow and worship Muhammad's words, Muhammad's Quran, have been convinced to think Muhammad's words are holy, so they call it the Holy Quran. It makes Mohammedans feel comfortable that a deity produced the words.
God Almighty says.
Realize this is the only phrase he may apply because he believes the Quran is magically from some deity. But the reality is that Muhammad claimed that he repeated words some angel said that some deity wrote. It is all hearsay. The actual accurate description is Muhammad says that Jibreel says that a spirit calling itself Allah says, not God Almighty says.
Inna ad-deena indallahi al-islam. So most certainly the religion that is acceptable in the sight of God is Islam.
So most certainly the religion that is acceptable in the sight of God is Islam. And here we have an example of Allah referring to himself in the third person. And make no mistake, Muhammad said that his religion was the only religion that was acceptable to him and to the spirit he claimed to speak for. I doubt a more self-serving claim has ever been made. Muhammad took great pains to claim his religion was acceptable to this Allah spirit. And by doing so, Muhammad set an example that to be real, the Allah you worship must name his religion and tell you what religion is acceptable.
Then what about Judaism? What about Christianity? Don't they exist? Are there no such faiths as Judaism and Christianity? I said, yes, not by name.
What about Judaism? What about Christianity? Don't they exist? Yes, but not by name. And that really should generate a big yawn, but not to someone childish enough to think Almighty God must say, "I am God, worship me," or "My religion is called Imalzi, and you must follow Imalzi."
These names didn't exist.
These names didn't exist. And here you have the first deception by diversion. These names didn't exist. Neither did Islam. Let that sink in for a moment. Deedat is attempting to claim the prophets followed Islam, a word and a name that never appears in the Torah or Bible, by claiming they did not follow the religion they did follow because the word or name is not in the Bible. This is called having your argument slain by your own sword. But if only it were that simple for Deedat to see his error.
You see, this word Judaism, where does it come from? You ask the Jew, the learned man of the Jew, ask him.
You ask the Jew, the learned man of the Jew, ask him.
Where does this word Judaism originate? Is it in your Bible?
Is it in your Bible?
The Bible of the Jews, the Old Testament, in this Christian Bible called the Holy Bible, is divided into two parts called the Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament is the Bible of the Jews.
The Old Testament is the Bible of the Jews. I'm sorry for all you who worship Muhammad's words, but this really just demonstrates how ignorant Deedat really was about Judaism and Christianity. Deedat simply does not understand what the testaments are all about, nor why there is an old and new. How can you think you intelligently worship your Allah when you are ignorant of things even your Allah says are equal with the Quran? Surah 2:136 commands you to respect the Torah and Bible as equal with the Quran. It says show no distinction. But I have never met a Mohammedan who respects Allah enough to honor Allah's command and read and know the Torah and Bible. Not even Deedat. You are without excuse, you who call yourself Muslim.
Now in this Old Testament, there are the first five books of this Old Testament called Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. And these are supposed to be the Torah. We say Torah. The Jew says Torah. Torah means the law. These first five books. This is the fundamental, the basis of the teachings of Moses.
This is the fundamental, the basis of the teachings of Moses.
Torah, Torah. Is this word Judaism to be found in the Torah? He says, no, it's not there.
He says, no, it's not there. Ask him if the word Islam is in the Torah. He'll say, no, it's not there. But this would be an act of intellectual honesty. If you are going to apply the test against one name, you must apply it equally against the name you advocate. Proverbs 11:1, a false balance is abomination to the Lord, but a just weight is his delight.
Is it in the Talmud? He says, no, it's not there.
He says, no, it's not there. Is the word Islam in the Talmud? He'll say, no, it's not there. You see, Mr. Deedat's attack kills his own argument.
Is it in the Mishnah? He says, no, it's not there. Then where did you get it? Where did you get this term Judaism from? Did Moses hear this word Judaism? He says, no, he never heard the term Judaism.
Moses never heard the word Judaism. And Moses never heard the term Islam. Proverbs 18:17. The first to present his case seems right, till another comes forward and questions him. If you are to try and make the claim that all the prophets followed your religion, you must do several things. One, you must attack the idea that they followed another religion, in effect, the one they really followed. In the case of all Jewish prophets, you must attack the fact they were Jews and that they followed the religion referred to as Judaism. You do this with a clever but childish attack against the existence of the word Judaism. You attack the word, claiming it does not exist and therefore is not the name of the religion. But this is based on a false assumption. It assumes Almighty God must give a name to his religion. I am God, and you must follow my religion, Imalzi. The only true religion is Imalzi. Because, well, of course, Imalzi, in some strange backwater language used by unlearned wanderers, means the only true religion. So this attack or jihad against the name Jews and the word Judaism is built on a faulty foundation to begin with. It assumes Almighty God must give a name to his religion. Number two, you must attempt to plant and establish the idea that they, the prophets, did follow the religion you advocate. And what is the easiest way to do that? It is simple, really. You just fill the vacuum. You put words someplace there are no words. In the case where the prophets did not say, I am a card-carrying member of Judaism, you make up words to claim they would say they were part of your religion. And the best way to do this is to make up a phrase and put it in their mouths. Make up a phrase that would imply, and most importantly, directly link to your false religion. If you want to claim they were Imalzi, you would do the following. Suggest that the prophets would say, if you could ask them what religion they followed, what was its name? Suggest the prophets would say they followed the one true religion. And then suggest the religion Imalzi is the one true religion. The name itself, the very name, means this thing. It is truly hard for the average trusting person to recognize such subtle lies, let alone refute them.
If Moses was alive today, if we can meet him personally, maybe in the hereafter, and if he had the opportunity of questioning him, he said, oh, Moses, tell us, what was your religion? What is the name of your religion that you are teaching?
What was your religion? What is the name of the religion you are teaching? Remember, suggest an imaginary conversation and put words in their mouth to directly link to your false religion.
I do not expect him to say Judaism.
I do not expect him to say Judaism, and I do not expect him to say Islam.
Because the poor man, he never heard the word.
And the man never heard the word Islam.
He never heard the word Judaism in his life.
And he never heard the word Islam in his life.
What do I expect him to say is that my religion is a religion of total submission to God's will.
What I expect him to say is, my religion is the religion of total submission to God's will.
A beautiful description, a lengthy description for the religion which he taught.
It's nice of Deedat to compliment himself. Nice, but totally self-serving. Think about it. Deedat has just concocted Moses saying some imaginary Islamic text. Then Deedat compliments his imaginary Moses for making the statement. See how clever and subtle the deception is. How incestuous. And Deedat has just inserted into the mouth of Moses, Moses claiming to speak his submission to Islam. At this point, you either accept the lie Deedat has inserted into Moses' mouth, or you call bullshit. Just keeping it real, G. This is the deceptive technique of Mohammedism. I actually think Moses would say something different. I think whatever Moses would say would align and agree with the rest of his message. Not jump completely sideways and mention concepts he never spoke of before, like submission to Allah. I think Moses would say, I worship the self-existing one. I worship the I Am. I worship Yahweh. I worship the God who made covenant with Abraham. I worship the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You see, all of these statements are consistent with everything Moses taught. Shoving the definition of Islam into his mouth? That's like dirty socks with athlete's foot fungus into the mouth of God's prophet Moses.
Now, one word for that in the Arabic language is Islam.
Now, one word for that in the Arabic language is Islam. Remember, I am God, and you must follow my religion, Islam. The only true religion is Islam. Because, well, of course, Islam, in some strange backwater language used by unlearned wanderers, means the only true religion.
He is giving a description.
He is giving a description. No. Moses is not giving a description. Deedat is selling you a bag of crap. Moses is not talking here. Deedat is the only one talking here. Can you see the bold-faced lie Deedat is peddling?
A religion of total submission to God's will.
A religion of total submission to God's will.
We say, that word, one word for that in Arabic is Islam.
One of Deedat's favorite techniques is to make up imaginary conversations. And this really is right out of Mohammed's playbook. Mohammed made up conversations between Jesus and God to put words in Jesus' mouth. Likewise, Deedat makes up this conversation with Moses to do the very same thing. And it is all fabrications. Lies. Damn lies. Mohammed's claims to repeat conversations by Jesus are also all lies. And Deedat's imaginary conversations with Moses are also lies. Do not be deceived by Deedat's lies or Mohammed's lies. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.